My name is Ayman Abdul Mohamed. I'm a PhD candidate at University of Technology in Malang. My research, this is a part of my PhD research. My supervisor is Professor Matthias Ahmed-Pusky. The title is not, this is a part of my title, okay, it's about removing, recycling concrete, and it's about removing the old adhesive mortar from a crushed concrete waste aggregate with a different hydrochloride acid and different molarity, and also measuring the effects on the properties of the aggregate. Actually, the recycling concrete aggregate terms have been introduced back to the Second World War. Since then, there's a lot of research being added to that field, but yet so far, recycling concrete aggregate is not really profitable to be used in a in a concrete industrial due to the inferior property compared to the natural aggregate. So that's why now the trend is to do treatment to recycled aggregate or recycled concrete to improve the properties and to be more sustainable for the sustainable environmental and for economical purpose and environmental also. If you see here, this is the typical recycled aggregate. So it's 64, about 35% adhesive mortar and 65% is natural aggregate. So our research is now to remove this 35% and restore the aggregate to its natural state. So the objective is of this paper is to measure the effectiveness of using hydrochloric acid to remove with a various with a different molarity to remove the old cement paste and here on the surface of that aggregate, okay, as a treatment method and its effects on the property of the property, the physical property of the aggregate, such as the crush. So we have the crush value aggregate and impact value aggregate and water absorption, and also to find the relationship between the molarity of hydrochloric acid and the size of the aggregate. So the experimental program, the material that we're using, we are using recycled concrete aggregate from a local in Kuala Lumpur. All building around 50 years old building was demolished recently, so we took that demolished particles and we recycle it. And also we are using hydrochloric acid with the molarity mass of 36.4 gram per mole. Now, we have made around 14 specimens starting from untreated aggregate, which is basically the nature of the natural status of the recycled aggregate without any treatment. And we have also a natural aggregate from natural aggregate. And we have done also some other different molarities starting from 0.2 and 0.5. Actually, using the hydrochloric acid is not also a big, have been introduced from different papers before, different researchers. We have also some researchers in Malaysia here that are using, but they are so far using only two molarities, 0.2 and 0.5. And this only, these two molarity is really very, very, very low, and it's not using the acid as a sole agent to treatment. They are using a combined method. We call it a pre-stripping method. After they remove only the first layer, or the first, we call the loose particles, okay? And after that, they are engaging into more advanced recycling, nano or something like that. But it's a costly, and it's a little bit, it's a more difficult and advanced. So this is a cost friendly and also much more easier. Now, the treatment of this, the treatment methods is we have 14 specimens of recycled aggregate. This is the sample, picture of the samples here. Okay, after that, we wash them with a water tap and then over dry them for 24 hours. After that, all the specimen will be submerged for 27 hours in the acid with all different properties. This is the during the submerging time. And then every 4 hours, we're taking this specimen and we overdry it again and weigh it to record the weight. Now, then the weight of the acid, all the specimen will be recorded for 4 hours, 8 hours, 24 hours, and 48 hours, and 72 hours. Okay, after that, for every record weight, they have to be overdried. After that, then the specimen will be retained in two. So after the 4 hours, we record the weight and then we retain into the acid again. So this here is the results, our research. So when we treatment of the crushed concrete with a different molarity, so we find out that increasing the molarity of the acids is highly associated or they are linked to the improving or the weight lose. So the more acid we use on the aggregate, the more weight the aggregate lose. So we assume that it will improve the properties of the aggregate, the physical properties of aggregate. Now, we found a relationship between the time and the weight of loss. So the aggregate start losing time after 4 hours, we measured that, until 8 hours. After that, basically, they are very, very slow of losing weight after 8 hours to 12 hours. But after 12 hours, there is no more losing weight. So basically, I think like 1 day something, the submerging the aggregate into the acid is for 24 hours is sufficient. This is the treatment of the crushed concrete with a different molarity. Here we show that, and a different size also. So, it shows that also that the smaller particles of aggregate shows that a higher weight loss than the 20 size of aggregate, 20 millimeter of aggregate. And also it shows that here, this is the 10, this is the 20, and the one is this is the 10. So the more the size of the aggregate, the results get better. This is the properties of the aggregate after the treatment. So now, here is a relationship, is we call it a negative relationship. Is the more weight the aggregate loss, the better results. So here with the aggregate, here we got the aggregate impact value. So as long as we have higher, so this is the natural aggregate, and here is the after recycling the aggregate and treatment with the highest molarity of 12.8 mole. So this is for the 0.2 and 0.5 mole of the hydrochloride. And this results for also the aggregate crash value. The same results was the same relationship. The more aggregate lose weight, the more improvement in the properties. And this one is the natural aggregate, and here is our after treatment. And this is the result, the previous result was published by some journals. So there are a lot of, actually there are about 30 to 35% improvement into the, in terms of the physical properties. And this is a water also absorption. Here is the water absorption for 10 mm and 20 mm for aggregate. We can see there's also, there's a lot of improvement. So here, this is the natural aggregate. So in terms of what the water absorption, their relationship a bit different. We call it positive relationship. So this means the nature of recycled aggregate is the old cement paste adhere on the surface of aggregate has a lot of pores. So when we use the hydrochloric acid to remove that, so the number of pores being decreased. So this two is a before treatment. Now with decrease, what after treatment is becoming here. This one is the natural aggregate with the less pores, and this is the after the highest molarity of aggregate 12.8, and it goes until here is that this is aggregate with the high pores without treatment, and here after treatment actually is increased after using hydrochloric acid with a very low molarity. So it we found that it makes more damage than it helps. And after we've done all the treatments, so we want also to confirm that with the macro structure level. So we use a digital microscope to take the image of the aggregate during the treatment stages. So actually, we have done for all the specimens, but for the limitation of the journals here or the conference, I have only put to compare between 0.2, which has been published previously from other researchers, and my work at 0.5. Now, this is the surface, the microstructure for our 500 zoom. So this is the surface of natural aggregate discovered by the old cement base. And after we use the 0.2 and 0.5, we have noticed that a lot of macro cracks appear on the surface here. There was also this kind of oil pores on the surface. Now, but after using the treatment, we have compared that to the surface of natural aggregate and the surface of the crushed concrete after being treated with 12.8, and it's as clean as the natural aggregate. We also have run all the information into the statistic analysis with using the SPSS software. So we put this in the matrix of the relationship between the variables. So as well as the relationship, we found all the relationship between the molarity of acids and the properties of aggregate is between significant relationship is like as long as we have the higher molarity, we have the higher results into the properties of aggregate. And here is the relationship between the also hydrochloric molarity and the properties of aggregate. So this graph for aggregate crush value. Okay, the relationship is a power relationship, and is the R value, the R squared value is 0.981. So it's like 98% chance that this relationship will become true when we use the molarity of when we use high molarity. So in aggregate impact value also the R squared is 0.98, so it's like 90% improvement or 90% this relationship is what comes through. And in terms of using the water absorption test, the relationship with was a linear relationship with R squared is 0.92 and 0.95. Still very good results, and it's as long as it's more than 0.7, that this is a strong relationship between changing the molarity of the acid or using higher molarity of acid to improve, to get a better results. As a conclusion, using hydrochloric acid as an agent or solo agent to remove the old adhere mortar from the surface of the aggregate was very successful, was very effective, especially when we're using the hydrochloric acid with a molarity of 10 and above. Also using the size of the aggregate is really important factors in the treatment process, as the smaller size of the aggregate shows a better results in the treatment. Now, the experimental program also use a lower hydrochloric acid molarity of 0.2 and 0.5 is not effective improvement it does not improve the properties as long. In fact, the treatment using the with the crushed concrete aggregate with a lower concentration of acid caused more micro cracks on the old cement base or old mortar adhered to the aggregate. Now, the treatment or the crushed concrete aggregate treated with the 10 up to 12.8 mole of hydrochloride achieve similar properties to the natural aggregate, while the recycled concrete aggregate treated with a lower molarity inferior properties as compared to the natural aggregate, which caused more damage to the existing mortar on the surface. Now, the experimental program shows significant influence on the hydrochloric acids on the properties of the crushed concrete waste aggregate. Thank you very much. This is a reference that we use already for your questions.